Welcome everybody to the 6th Fear and Fail Conference. For those of you who are still not sure what a Fear and Fail Conference is, I shall give it a brief description.
Please leave now.
Please leave now, yeah. Fear and Fail is what it is. It's a way of getting someone's story out there. It's a way of being vulnerable, being heard. Everybody deserves to be listened to. It's a way of breaking out of your comfort zone. It's a way of developing yourself, even. And it helps you come to realizations that you may not have realized before. It can be very powerful. We ask you to be gentle with our speakers, very brave speakers this evening. We have Ali, Evert, and Brigitte this evening speaking. Evert's going to go first, so we're going to have to give him a really big round of applause. Not yet. We have a little surprise for you before we do that. I don't know if you're nearly ready for that.
Yeah.
Okay. Generation Why Not generously allows us to use their space, and Rad Miller and I co-organised with the help of Eric. Lots of events here, so if you're interested in finding out more about that as well, please let us know. We like renting out the space too. I think, basically, that's it. The last thing I would say before we get started is turn your mobile phones off. There's nothing more disrupting than a mobile phone going off halfway through someone's personal story. Just put it on airplane mode or silent, or turn it down, discreet, have the vibrations going off in your pocket. But Mission Impossible soundtracks sounds bad when you're trying to open your heart on top of that. You see? Rad Miller has a couple of words.
So when we started this in March this year, we had no idea we would be reaching our 6th event this year.
It's true.
So Andy and me are very happy welcoming you. Some of you will be seen often. Thank you for coming back and returning. This is our method for being more human, being more connected, inspiring people. Working on our personal development and empowerment. And I am personally a member of Fear and Fail Network from 2014, and we keep spreading these vibes throughout the globe. So this is now 7th country where we have these events. And I want to thank you for being brave and coming here. Every time you have three amazing people being willing to be open, vulnerable, and share their failures and their fears. What is so different about this event is that we started studying, researching what are the traits of entrepreneurship, right? Because the new age wants us to take more things into our own hands. And we realized that actually it's the relationship with failures and fears that has the power to make you more entrepreneurial, more able to take destiny into your own hands. But what is the key to success? The key to success, or put in our words, a key to more fulfilling and meaningful life, is how we view our failures. Okay, how we view our failures. The answer, and a quick tip, is we should view our failures as a puzzle which gives us little gems, little treasures, if we solve them. So only if we solve them. And this is all very easy, right? But there is a big but there. What's the big but? You have any idea? If this is so easy, why are we not learning from our failures and mistakes? Why are we keep repeating the same things?
Our perceptions.
Mm-hmm.
And misconceptions.
Yeah, absolutely. Any other ideas?
Our mindset. If we don't change our mindset, I think we're going to involuntarily take the same steps.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. Perhaps it could be our upbringing or culture or educational system or working culture that has never given us a direction to actually connect our fears with our failures. So once we realize that we have fears which are motivating us to fail, and until we address these fears, you're not going to break the pattern, okay? So this is what we do with our speakers. We always thank them for volunteering to do this, we talk with them and we prepare them to shape their story, to start with a failure. But failure is not the end. Failure is only the context. It's providing the context. What is much more important is the underlying fear. It's what's beneath. This is why we call this event a conference for breaking the surface. So talking about something which is more deep. Okay?